if you remember, Don, but we did it with a hot water tour. It was Bill Stone that started doing that, and now we've brought it back again, but it's a little bit different, this
You're
type of IROC.
You're still bringing your own boat, right? You don't. Are they? They're just swapping out. They're not swapping out.
Yes, yes. See, you, exactly. You know, the promoter ain't providing the boats.
Gotcha.
Okay, so you're bringing your own boat. It's got to be 1,000 cc's or under. Uh-oh, and Eric Gabriel looked like he has some issues there, so we're going red. It looks like. I see red people. The red flag coming out. They'll bring him back to the line. Repack, restack, re-rack, restart this one all over again. And somebody was calling for a two-minute hold, I think, down there, or possibly a misjudged band deal. And we've had that, you know, because the rubber band, the rubber band mechanism, it's down there on the starting line.
Yes.
A lot of folks don't realize is actually controlled by an air compressor. And guess what? It's a machine. Sometimes machines break.
What? Never.
I'm just saying.
So crazy talk.
So yeah, yeah. You have to, you know, you have to allow for that, and you throw in a little bit of human error, and stuff happens.
All right. So we're thinking possibly two reasons for this particular red flag. One would have been a mechanical error, as Mike had talked about, which we only haven't had that too much on the tour, but a couple of times we've had some slow starts, or maybe one side started slower than the other.
You know, one thing that I'm looking at is Gabriel right now, Gabriel Sr., Eric, Easy E.
Sucked up something maybe underneath the boat.
It might have been the rubber band.
So they are, in fact, asking for that two-minute hold.
And you can see Kevin Scott. Our starter down there is working his way up with some new rubber bands. So,
my how things can change in one day, 24 hours. Yesterday we had pretty perfect race conditions, a little bit partly cloudy. We had some good temperatures, nice and warm. Low humidity compared to last week, but man, today definitely 10 degrees cooler at the moment over here, and as we roll on the river for the national championship.
I tell you, I'm really loving the overcast today.
I am too.
This is the coolest race on tour.
In more ways than one.
Exactly.
Definitely going to help the riders out as well as far as tuning the boats. Whenever they have to deal with temperature conditions, humidity.
Don, yeah, that's one thing. You know, we didn't really touch on this much yesterday. You know, we did talk about the weather being just a little bit cooler, but the water. What's the water temperature like? And are, the boats are running better in the cooler water. Am I correct?
Yeah, absolutely. So when you have real hot temperatures on land and on the water, you've got to watch how you're going to be working with the temperatures in the boat. So the ideal conditions, regardless whether you have a two-stroke or a four-stroke, is to have a little bit cooler air conditions, a little bit cooler temperatures from the water and the air. But yeah, I mean, it can definitely make a massive difference. Humidity will make a difference. Elevation will make a difference on the boats.
Well, at least we're not elevated that much.
I'm always elevated, and I know you are.
Well, we're always at least two stories above sea level.
Correct. but yeah, elevation is a massive. You'd have a boat maybe that would run, well, let's say 60 miles an hour at sea level. You take that same boat up to Denver, Colorado, and I would know about this because we had that issue.
Right.
It'll run about 51 miles an hour.
Back when Rusty Latimer was putting on races up there in Denver.
Oh, my gosh. You just don't remember or forget a thing, do you?
No, I try not to.
No, that's Rusty Latimer was. Now, so the way the racing works around the country, which is what Mike Young is referring to, is that we have local and regional promoters as well as our national tour operator, which AJ Handler and Jennifer and the crew put on this national tour. But, yeah, we have local promoters as well, and that's really where we farm our talent up. And Rusty Latimer was in region number 4, which was the Midwest.
Oh yeah, Denver, Colorado. I remember.
I know you do. And then there's other regions that are sort of famous, actually. And in fact, we've had quite a bit of spirited conversation about this every time we talk regions, right?
Well, you know, and that's the funny thing is because I think all the racers down there, you know, at least the older ones understand what we're talking about because, you know, you had region 1 through 8.
Eight balls.
Exactly. The crazy eights. Yep. The crazy eights, which Kevin Kennedy is still representing, who's here this weekend.
Yeah.
And, you know, I grew up in Region 6, which was kind of the Midwest of the United States. And man, we thought we were the best. But then I moved down to Region 7, and I trained them to be the best.
Oh, here we go. Oh, my gosh. It has already started. I'm waiting for Carson to pipe in. He's been shockingly quiet.
Hey, Carson was Region 6, man. You know, I was putting on races with his dad.
Rick Ignacio is saying Region 2, and I remember Region 1 and Region 2, and I think that's
California.
Yeah,
California, Washington, Oregon. Yeah.
The Redingers come from Region 1, Region 2 racing. All right, Eric Gabriel Sr., I believe, with the whole shot.
Yeah, Eric Gabriel Sr., with the early lead. And hey, Don, by the way, you know, it is a smaller race out here. We can talk about some other stuff. Talk about Hidden Trails Motorsports. Man, I'll tell you what, special thanks to Cameron and Trey Frame, the Frame family. Man, they put on an amazing little shindig last night.
Well, they certainly did. But, I mean, if you just look back over the last couple of years and all they've done, and this is really a small snapshot of the type of participation, but they sponsor events. They have given discounts to the riders throughout the year. And when I say discounts, big. I mean, they've really marked down stuff to help these guys out. They put a lot of money into the sport. They have come out in force, right? They've brought a ton of boats, big trailer. They got Tim Ducat on their team. So I just think it's very indicative of these guys. And they run a great operation. You know, they're running dealerships midweek, right?
Way cool. Did you go upstairs last night?
I didn't see the Les Cook Sparkle.
Oh, my goodness.
And I bummed out, too, because I wanted to see the track. Now, you do know I've been on that.
Spark motor, stand-up haul.
I told
you. Oh, snap.
I'll tell you,
another four-stroke. Oh, my goodness, in the stand-up class. I love it.
Kylie Elmers and Les Cook, the new track boat. And by the way, that is the boat that Redderer has been riding. It's been a modified boat, but that's the one that he took the two world titles on a couple years ago.
Yeah, exactly.
That's what
we seen one upstairs last night. That's what we were talking about. It's Eric Gabriel, your early leader, followed by boat number 52, Eric Gabriel Jr.
I don't know if he really wants us to call him Junior.
Right.
Sean Miles, I think, for
EJ and EZE. How's that?
Oh, it's Drew Horn, actually. Boat number 607, top 3. And he'd race number 3.
Yeah, race number 3, I believe, is already in the gate. These are the juniors. They are squared away.
There you go. Just take these.
You gotta have
them.
No, you're fine.
Well, I'm after 10. I'm on the way back to Florida.
Junior ski stock. I need to have junior ski stock. Well, look at them. They're already ready. They're like, Don, we're ready.
It's like, yeah, exactly. They were ready last night.
Awesome.
Here we go. Still Eric Gabriel in the lead as he works his way down that semi front straightaway. And we say semi because it's kind of abbreviated, Don. Just over here on the left-hand side of the track, only about, 30, 40 yards. Again, race number 3 down on the line. Race number 4, you need to stand by. That is the Vets Runabout Box Stock, Amateur Runabout Super Stock, and Vets Runabout Open.
Yeah, because I know he's been running the film classes, so I bet that racers will come in on that one.
Well, it's again Eric Gabriel. And Don, I think I touched on this a little bit yesterday. You know, Eric raced for many, many years. Him and his brother, Teddy, used to race with us back on the Midwest Tour. Actually, when Carson was racing. Carson probably raced against Eric and Teddy Gabriel.
Did
back
you really?
In the day. Our race director up here. He took 15 years off and had two kids, and then now he's out here racing with his kid.
That was back in the Pilgrim Motorsports days.
Pilgrim Motorsports.
Jack LaHockey, Pilgrim Motorsports, Aaron.
Oh, my gosh. Do you have any Gabriel stories?
Baumgartner. Pilgrim Motorsports used to be a big sponsor of the Midwest Watercross Tour, which, you know, basically West Virginia was a part of it. You know, West Virginia, Ohio, Indiana, Illinois, Michigan. You know, it was the whole Midwest deal, and it was one of the biggest shows around. But again, that's circa 25 years ago.
Not that we're dating ourselves at all here. Local sponsors, by the way, I do want to do a special thanks to Charleston Convention and Visitors Bureau, Daniel Electric, Rodney Loftus and Sons, Bossy Electric, the Monkey Barrel. Still trying to figure out what that is. Summit Credit, because I think that could be cool. Summit Credit.
I think it's a food truck.
Oh, is it really?
I think the Monkey Barrel is a food truck. I'm going to throw it out there.
ADMC.MX. Also, Sunbelt Rentals, the paint store. Shamblin' Stone Inn, Elko Mechanical Contractors. Marty's Tires, Dolan and Koloski Orthodontics, J-Class Collision, and Goldfarb Electric. I want to say a special thanks to all of our local sponsors. Checker flag goes out for Eric Gabriel Sr. Congratulations.
Do we have the points up here today by chance?
I stole them, but I have them.
I was going to see if Eric Gabriel actually took the national championship in this one, because I believe he did. Eric came down to Pensacola and Panama City with us back in May. And it's been in Hartwell. Not quite sure if he was in Atlantic City.
Yeah, he was in Atlantic City?
Okay. So he probably took the overall title for the national tour as well.
So it's actually Sean Miles. Well, let's see. It was the IROC class, right? Yeah, Sean Miles came into this with the lead with 312 points. It was Eric with 293.
And this is double points. And Miles not in this one.
Yep, and Justin Gabriel was third, so it looks like both Erics are going to be moving to that podium.
Miles will still make the podium in that class, even though he's not racing in that class.
Yeah.
Okay.
So
that Drew Horn. How about Drew Horn? Cincinnati, Ohio, baby. I love me some Cincinnati. Used to be a Reds fan when I was a kid growing up. Johnny Bench, Joe Morgan. Back in the Dizzle.
Junior Stock is going to be coming out of this gate in just a minute. And while we get ready to do the rundown real quickly on the points, it's Sam Neamy. And on that 10 to 12-year-old class with 303 points currently in the lead. And Devin Farthing with 233 points in second. Hayden Skellett, 240 points in third.
One thing I would like to make mention of here, Don, you know, Hayden Skellett currently in third place, even though he's in third place, hasn't lost a single moto. When he's been racing, he did not come to the West Coast.
And he has two stops, actually, and he's currently trying to get a hole shot.
Yeah, he did. He grabbed a hole shot. Sammy Neamy right beside him as they work their way left to right, as we view it, Charleston, West Virginia. By the way, I'd like to say a very special thanks to Samantha Carney and all the fine folks that visit West Virginia. And visit Charleston, the Convention and Visitors Bureau. Man, these guys have really went the distance for us. They always do. And we sure are very appreciative, as this is our eighth year here in Charleston.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, these guys definitely roll out the red carpet. And even though we had a little bit of rain today and a little bit last night, man, I tell you what, has not dampened the spirits. And what's really cool is that we are working our way through these classes today. And I am so excited that we're going to get to award some national championships.
Yes, me too. Here comes Skellett. Around the bubble he goes. Got about a three-second advantage right now over Sammy Neamy Jr. And again, as you pointed out, Sammy Neamy Jr., he's sitting in the driver's seat. He is he's in first place coming out here. He's got a 2-2 yesterday as far as his finishes. Skellett, though, man, this kid's unbeatable.
going to tell you what, I just got to do some props here for this Underhill team. If you look back in third, that's Brett Underhill, who just started racing last year. He's only been at a handful of races at most. And they don't have a big team yet down in Florida, but I'm just going to make a quick prediction here. If this continues to grow like it is with between him and Avery and some of these other riders, I think Florida could be a junior contingent big time.
Yeah, I think Avery's going to push Brett.
Oh, I have no
I really
question.
Do.
Yeah, no question. I'm sure Wendy's down there going, uh-huh.
That's what's going on.
So Brett right now is in the lead for 13 to 15. Now coming into this round, though, it's AJ Lewinstra on boat number 114 that is setting it up for a national championship. Meanwhile, Hayden, with this finish, Mike, I've got to think is going to work his way up the podium.
Unbeatable.
Really cool.
Yeah, I'll tell you, the kid, like I said yesterday, for those of you folks that weren't here yesterday, I'll reiterate, Hayden Skellett actually raced in the GP class against the top pros down at the Surf and Turf Championships this year and won.
Oh, wow.
And there are some top pros that you'll see out in a GP class here today that he beat. But I'm not going to mention any names because I don't want to embarrass anybody.
So count about just a little bit. We've got Hayden Skellett in first, Sam Nimi in second, and then we have Taylor Skellett in third. Dev Farthing is in fourth, and looks like Oz Ilar in fifth. That is your line as it stands right now, anyway, on the track for the 10 to 12 class. When you look back on the 13 to 15, it's Brett Underhill. And Brett still leading. Brett, awesome.
Yeah. Brett's actually beaten AJ Lewinstra and AJ and yep. Wyatt Hayes. I mean, those are two really good riders, man.
They are very good riders. Wyatt is in second, just coming out of that inside split. So he's about 25 seconds off the pace at the moment behind the leader. So really all Brett's got to do is, at this point, hold on, stay in that position. And he will have his very first moto win.
Yeah, how about that?
And I bet
special things happen in West Virginia.
Yeah, absolutely. I bet mom's down there chewing on nails.
Hey, guys. I'd like to do amateur awards before pro show. I'm thinking we'll finish at 11:30.
That'd be awesome.
Can you do that?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Okay, race number four, need to have you guys on the line now. Race number four, thanks for your help today in staging so that we can be on time. Now, listen, one thing I just heard from Carson, Mike, what'd you just hear?
Amateur awards before we go into the pro show.
Bam, I love that idea.
Yeah, me too. It's a long drive.
Well, not just that, but that allows everybody to get some awards. We can celebrate.
I like it.
Ooh. Hayden Skellett already started laps.
Look at home Skellett. By the way, did I show you my new shirt?
Oh, my gosh. You're representing for Skellett Motorsports.
Skellett Motorsports, baby. I'll tell you, those... Between Hayden and Taylor, those two kids right there, just absolutely amazing kids. I don't know if you you heard the interview I got to do with Taylor yesterday.
Oh, yeah, I did. I could hear it. She's adorable.
She is not only adorable, she's going to be a spokesmodel for somebody somewhere someday.
Yeah.
Guaranteed, because this girl is not shy.
No. And she is a great little racer. She's currently in third, by the way.
Yeah, you see her working the top left-hand side of the track.
Looks like
still
Oz.
She's in front of AJ Lewinstra.
Oz Ilar just went down, by the way, on the left-hand side of the track. Tough break for him. Looks like Mike's already over there to pick him up. I'm sorry. Go ahead, sir.
You mean Bee Sting.
We'll just call him Sting.
Stung.
You are mean.
No, I just call it as I see it.
That's true.
That's all.
I love you.
All right. Straight up.
No change in the top three thus far. Well, there's one minor change. Brett Underhill actually getting a little company with Wyatt. And are we at the white flag yet?
I see a yellow flag because we got a couple riders that got mixed up down here on the bottom right-hand side of the track.
Uh-oh. Is that Taylor? Looks like Taylor and Oz, maybe?
Yeah, possibly Taylor and Oz. No, that's Taylor out here.
Oh, no, Taylor's still riding. So, no, that it was Taylor.
Oh, yeah.
It was Taylor. So Taylor and Oz got in a little mix up just coming onto that front stretch, but they're both back up and roll. Actually, it wasn't Oz, it's Avery. Taylor and Avery getting a little sideways.
I'll tell you, Hayden doing an absolutely amazing job. You know, the other thing that I realized yesterday after the event, which, you know, is sometimes hindsight's 20/20, but you know, as long as you reiterate it and as long as you let people know, you know, you're human and everybody makes mistakes. Like I said, Hayden Skellett has not lost a moto this year. Unfortunately for Hayden, he did not come to the West Coast stops out to Reno and St. George, Utah. Currently sits third in the points, right?
Yeah, I was just going to say, he's even with missing those two, he's still sitting in a podium position.
Well, it's funny because he talked to his papa yesterday, and Pop came up to me and said, hey, why don't you guys interview Hayden? And I told him, I said, because Hayden didn't come up and talk to us.
White flag is out for Mr. Shy Guy.
Don't be shy.
Yeah, that kid is fast. I like that. Give me curse. It's like, that kid is fast.
Hayden Skelly. This kid's going to be a force to be contended with. Remember, he's representing the 10 to 12-year-old. He's not the 13 to 15-year-old. He's representing the 10 to 12-year-olds.
All right, so a final lap for Brett Underhill, gentleman that is poised to take his very first moto win. He's got a lot of traffic that he's having to deal with. Looks like Oz once again. Oz, very unusual to see that gentleman fall off his boat. That's a couple of times now today that I've seen him go off. So I'm just kind of wondering if something's going on with the boat today.
Yeah,
that's just unusual.
Going back to Underhill, his rookie season, looks like he may finish on the podium in his first ever pro watercross tour.
Oh, yeah.
Checker flag out, ladies and gentlemen, and how about a nice round of applause for Hayden Skellett. Hayden Skellett making it happen. Captain, again, he's sponsored by Wade Chapin Performance, as well as Action Jet Sports, PC Security, and Casey Moulton and the folks over at IPD Graphics.
And we've got a drag race, and right at the final turn, Wyatt Hayes took the inside split on the final lap and beat Brett Underhill. You beat Brett Underhill by about 3 feet. Oh, what a tough break. That gentleman rode awesome.
Taking a look down, Devin Farthing. Looked like he came in third place, a 5-3-3. Checking to see if that will put him onto the podium. He's going to be close. I believe that is going to put him onto the podium, as Sam Neamey will probably come in second. Hayden will be first.
Well, that'll probably be just enough, too, as well, because Devin Farthing came into this final round with 283 points, so he is going to be sitting on this podium. Hayden Skellett and Sam Neamey is how it looks thus far for our podium finishes.
And how about it for Brent Underhill, Pensacola, Florida, being represented. Looks like Jeff Dykowski with a hole shot on the eight ball. Jeff Dykowski out of Rydell, Georgia, riding for Metal Roofing Manufacturing, as well as Reva and Dean's team. You're watching the Veterans Runabout Box Stock, Amateur Runabout Super Stock, and Vets Runabout Open. This is race number 4, a 3-way kicker. And it's going to be Dykowski from the outside as the green flag flies. Here in beautiful Charleston, West Virginia, ladies and gentlemen, we are in God's country. Lester, boat number 35, in that second place position. Again, Jason Lester out of South Leon, Michigan, riding for JBL Med 1, as well as Reva and Jet Pilot. In the third spot, Brian Futch out of Charlotte, North Carolina, riding for Champion Motorsports. Charlotte, North Carolina, that's where a bunch of our riders got stranded this weekend on the way to get to Charleston, and United said, we know fly.
We know fly. Oh, good times.
So you rent a Kia and invite all your best friends.
We have those other batteries.
Kia. Race number five, we need you down to the starting line. Race number five, down to the starting line. Once again, that is the Women's Ski Limited Beginner Ski Stock. Women's Ski Limited Beginner Ski Stock, race number five. Jeff Dykowski is your leader. Big D down the front straight away. And he has got the courtesy flags up. And again, spectators, if you see the white flag and the checkered flag rolled up and crossed, that means that the race is halfway complete, which you're seeing from our flag man right now. All right, here comes your leader from the bottom right-hand side of the track, still Jeff Dykowski.
Oh, you're on the live stream too.
By the way, we'd like to welcome everybody who is watching our Visit West Virginia live stream. We had no idea we were streaming yet.
No. Whoopsie.
It's so early. It's so Sunday.
Only you would say 10:30 is early, my friend.
Well,
love you.
I'm on West Coast time.
Wait, is it different?
Well, yeah, it is different. Right now on the West Coast, current time is 7:30.
You're goofy. Come here, darling. Wait a minute. How can you be on West Coast time when you're from Florida?
Well, I'll be in the West Coast in 3 weeks. I'm trying to prepare.
All right.
You're a problem solver.
Because I'm a problem solver. That's right. Proper planning.
Ooh.
Ooh. All right. Jeff Dykowski, speaking of planning, man, this guy planned to come out on tour and kick donkey all year long. And you know what?
He has been.
He has been. You know, owns metal roofing manufacturing back in Riddell, Georgia. Dave Bamdis and Company out at Riva sponsor him and help him out. Don, what do you think? Where is Jeff at in the points? I think he's about ready to close in on a national championship here in his class.
He is. Yeah, he's every time he has stepped up to the starting line on this runabout stock class, he has won as well. So he came into this round with 240 points and currently leading, Mike. And we do need what?
Race number five, Women's Ski Limited and Beginner Ski Stock. Women's Ski Limited and Beginner Ski Stock. We need you to the starting line ASAP. The checkered flag is out, and nobody's online. Women's Ski Limited, Nikki Turner, Leslie Horn, Shay Turner, Vicky Hanna, you should be online. So congratulations again to Jeff Dykowski, who, you know what? I think he's going to take a victory lap saying, hey, I just won a national championship.
Na, 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 na. Sports Stock, you are on deck. So I do need to have Women's Ski Limited, Beginner Ski Stock, Sports Stock, you're on deck.
We were never late.
Yeah.
Okay, Mike. Mike disagree.
No, I agree with you. The women, fucking, they were on point.
Oh, yeah, friend, folks. Four. That's right. Feel free to put on them dancing shoes. Yeah.
Got Jason Lester, I do believe, coming in second. And you're already dancing. What is up with you?
You know, I am dancing. You know, and speaking of dancing, we want to dance with Hayden Skellett. Hey, Hayden. Hayden, can you come up to the announcing tower? We want to talk to you, buddy. By the way, big shout out to Craig over there, EVP, Pro Beach Volleyball, done as of yesterday, but Craig's still the hardest working man in show business. We love you from the Tower of Power, Craig. All right, we're going to get Home Skelet up here.
Hayden, get you
Look at them dimples.
All right, Mikey, I think you better interview young man.
Now, Hayden, you never get a chance to get interviewed, but you never hear how we talk about you out there. But let me tell you something. I think you did an amazing job this year, son. I know that you guys do a lot of practice, and is it your sister that pushes you to your excellence?
Yeah.
It is? Well, how about your mom and dad? How important are they to you with your racing program?
Very much. They help me do everything.
We're going to look at the camera here. They help you do everything. And I know that, we talked about this while you were out there. You probably couldn't hear us, but you know that this year you won every moto that you were in the junior class.
Yeah. Trying to sweep the whole title.
Trying to sweep the whole title?
Yeah.
Do you think maybe if you ask somebody, you could move up to pro?
They won't let me.
They won't let you move up to pro? Do you think you can beat some of the pros out there?
Yes.
You definitely think you can beat some of the pros. Now, is this in a GP class or in a stock class?
Stock.
In a stock class. Well, I'll tell you what, man. We're all very proud of you, and I know that your sponsors are proud of you, too. Would you like to say a thanks to all of your sponsors?
Thank you for helping me get here and helping me hold and helping. Like every part of the way, yeah.
Now, I understand you're pretty smart in school, too.
Yeah.
You're an honor roll student?
No.
No, hold on a second. Now, Taylor told me that you got straight A's.
I did? Gavin gets straight A's.
Sometimes.
You get straight A's sometimes. Yeah. What kind of grade do you get in gym?
A.
You get an A in gym. Okay. See, that's all that matters because you're a jet ski racer. As long as you get an A in gym, you're all right.
It's called PE, Mike Young.
Physical education. That's something obviously I've been lacking.
You're all good.
Now, is Talon your buddy over here?
Yes.
You and Talon Farling hang out? Talon, are you his biggest fan?
No.
Are you Devin's biggest fan?
Yeah.
All right. So where's Dev Dog at, man? Now you and Devin have been fighting it out. Do you think both of you guys might hit the podium tonight? You and Devin, who's going to be second?
He is.
You think he is after the double points?
Yeah, I don't have enough points to catch up.
You didn't go to Reno and St. George, right?
Yeah.
Did you have something going on then? You had a thing?
Yeah.
All right. Yeah, I had a thing. Fantastic. Well, listen, man, we'd like to say congratulations. Awesome job. And you're definitely going to be a force to be reckoned with in the years coming.
He's already a force to be reckoned with.
Hey, Taylor, are you ever going to beat your brother?
When I grow up, I'm thinking of beating him.
Well, how much more you got to grow?
Oh, now. 20 feet.
No, I just wanted to grow like 2 feet.
Yeah, you go 2 more feet, you might be in beach volleyball.
No, I'm going to stay over here in the water.
You got to be tiny to be good?
It makes you go faster so you don't have to lean back the whole time.
Oh, so you got to be built like a horse jockey.
Yeah.
Yeah. These kids are awesome.
It's good that we're getting all these tips. So now we know how to be faster on the water as well. You've been listening to the interview with Mike Young.
I need to lose some weight and grow taller, I guess.
And Hayden Skellett. Oh, my gosh. And Taylor Skellett. And, of course, Talon Farthing, who we're still trying to talk into racing. But and what is your name? Hi, Noah. Well, you come on up here, too. Hey, and then we'll just say goodbye to everybody on the stream.
Exactly. He gets the cool jacket award.
He does get the cool jacket award. All right, you guys, we're hanging out here in Charleston, West Virginia. And as you can see, we're already starting to talk about these new national champions for 2016. We'll be back with even more.
I'll tell you what, I cannot wait. You guys all wave to the camera. Hey, say hey. See yourself on TV.
Hi.
Whoa, bye. All right, let's go back out to the race course. Don Dawson, thank you, juniors,
thank
for coming
you guys.
Up. Hayden, great job, buddy.
Good job, bud.
All right, we got you. We got you, Talon. Once again, folks. Women's Ski Limited Beginner Ski Stock is out there right now. It's the double lot, Nikki Turner. She is your leader out of Cornelius, North Carolina.
And Nikki on her way to a women's national title. And great to see these brand new riders out here on the beginner ski.
You know, one thing, Dawn, this is the first time that we've actually had four ladies on the course all at once, even though two of them are representing the beginners and two of them are representing the women's ski limited class.
Well, I think it's awesome that we've got Shay out there, you know, Callaway and Nikki. Nikki's mom, Shay Turner, this is her first appearance, and we got a chance to catch up with her today. It was interesting. She goes, you know, I'm not sure I'm really all the competitive type, but it was definitely fun to be out there racing. It gives a whole new respect to what these riders have to do. And then Vicky Hanna, of course, out of Chapel Hills, North Carolina, sponsored by Hurricane Performance, Amsoil, and 321 Kawasaki. It's her first time ever on the track as well.
Chapel Hill, isn't that where Duke University's from?
I don't. Yes, it is, isn't it?
Yeah, I believe so.
I actually didn't catch that.
Yeah, Mike Krzyzewski, man, most winningest college coach ever.
Look at you, like, being all smart sports-wise.
It's raining. Well, I'll tell you what, Don, it feels like we got some liquid sunshine coming down.
Don't.
Just, it's liquid sunshine. It's still sunshine.
Don't rain. All right, you're watching Women's Ski Limited and Beginner Ski Stock. I do need to have race number six on the line, please. Race number six on the line. That's going to be Sport Stock. Please, which is a short class, by the way, guys. This is already halfway through this class on a lap, so I need to have Sport Stock on the line right now, please. Sport Stock. Thank you.
Yeah, and I'll tell you, I believe we got like 18 Sport Stock riders for those of you folks that might be listening in on the Visit West Virginia live stream.
And you can actually see Shay coming through there on borrowed property. And looks like, actually, Vicky Hanna looks like she's doing a heck of a... Did she just switch legs? Did I just see that?
Yeah, she did the old switch foot.
I am so impressed.
Yeah.
Oh,
obviously,
awesome.
Obviously, she's been going to school.
I guess. Leslie Horn also out there. She's racing in the Women's Ski Limited. She's out of Cincinnati, Ohio, by the way, and she is sponsored by her best brother in the world, Drew Horn. How cool is that?
Aww. And there's Drew. What's going on, D? How you doing, buddy?
I want to know how you talked her into getting out there.
Right. It was a bet. It was late at night. It was one of those things.
Bribes happen.
And you won.
Well, it's awesome that she's out here. She's doing a great job, by the way. Nikki Turner poured the gas on that back. You know what's cool about this?
Nikki keeps getting faster,
exactly.
Faster, and faster.
You totally stole my thought.
Kind of under the radar, but I've been watching.
And
I'll keep my eye on her.
Really good in surf. I was very impressed with her in the surf races this year. All right, again, Sports Stock. I need to have you on the line. Sports Stock, need to have you guys down the line.
Thank you.
Hey, by the way, if everybody's having a great time here, make sure you join us in Naples, Florida. What's going on in Naples, Don?
World Championship.
World Championships, Hydro Flight Championships, Hydro Drag Nationals. OMG, it's 10 days. 10 days of high-speed, full-contact fiberglass warfare.
You're so cute. By the way, checker flag drops for Nikki Turner, which is why I need to have all the Sports Stocks on the line. Hint.
Yeah, exactly, because Nikki's going to come by before y'all get online. So, Don just saying, get online. Come on, sport guys.
Get on the line.
And gals. Once again, Sports Stock coming up next. That's race number six. Race number seven, Amateur Ski GP. Combined with the Ski Limited class, we're going to need you to pre-staging.
Susan Anderson. Man, what a story yesterday with that hole shot. In fact, so cool. First time I've seen her get a hole shot this year. And I looked down without even thinking because she has an HX as well. And it's a tiny bit similar, especially from the tower. It looks a little similar to Kelly Smith's. And I was announcing Kelly Smith and I'm like, wait a minute, that's Susan Anderson's number. Too cool. All right, ladies, don't put your hands together for our second place women's limited class.
Yeah, Nikki Turner taking the win.
And it is going to be Leslie Horn for second.
Way to go, Leslie.
And I do believe Shay Turner won for Beginner Ski Stock, and Vicky Hanna got second. That, as they say, is a wrap.
That is a, yeah, exactly. But there ain't no chicken in it. Ain't no turkey in it. Just a wrap. Plain.
Just a plain. He's so silly.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, race number six is coming up next. And down there on the deuce out of Clearwater, Florida, taking a 7-7 finish yesterday, riding for Riva Racing, HydroTurf, and ClearwaterMortgageBroker.com, as well as Team Scream. That's Gage Schoenherr. Out of Allentown, Michigan, riding atop a Sea-Doo, sponsored by Riva Racing, IPD Graphics, and the Sea-Doo Bounty X team. Boat number three is Eric Gabriel. Boat number 08 out of Landrum, South Carolina, riding atop a Yamaha, sponsored by Fly Racing, Jet Pilot, Jet Trim, Hot Products, and HydroTurf, Devin Walker. Out of Cooper City, Florida, your current points leader, taking a 1-3 finish yesterday, riding for Broward Motorsports, Judge Motorsports, Exotic Signs, Shoei, Jet Pilot, Wimbledon's, iSaw, Jet Lift, and Thrust Innovations, Sam Nimi.
Out of Naples, Florida, sponsored by Wade Chapin Performance, Broward Motorsports, Exotic Signs, and Wimbledon's Customs, is boat number 14, Keith Dill.
Keith, my wingman, Dill.
Oh, man, so I heard. Corruption continues.
Exactly. Sean Reynolds is on boat number 18, folks. He also comes from Naples, and he rides for Ams Oil and Scott Goggles.
And out of Suffolk, Virginia. Oh, I get to announce this one again. Boat number 31, sponsored by Ambassol.
Team Ambassol.
That is correct. And apparently Viagra, new sponsor for him.
That's what I hear.
2016 tour.
The Purple Pill.
Also, down I am in so much trouble, aren't I? Out of South Lyon, Michigan, sponsored by JBL, Med One, HDD, Riva, Jet Pilot. It is boat number 35, Jason Lester.
Boat number 42 comes to us from Spotsylvania, Virginia, rather. Spotsylvania, Virginia. Wow, it's like Pennsylvania.
Transylvania,
yeah,
it's like for a minute.
Exactly. It's Count Dracula. No, it's actually David Prudhomme.
Also, out of Pembroke Pines, that was hilarious. Pembroke Pines, Florida, sponsored by Broward Motorsports, Team Main Racing, and I Saw Cameras. Boat number 69, Ray Quintana.
Boat number 95 out of Davie, Florida, riding for Broward Motorsports, Team Mean Racing, Exotic Signs, Judge Motorsports, Wet Spot Racing, and his lovely girlfriend, Jan. That is Kenny Waddle.
Out of Lake Worth, Florida, sponsored by WRT Exotic Signs, Riva Racing, and Dave's Auto Body. Boat number 114, and your hole shot winner yesterday,
yeah,
and second overall yesterday, Susan Anderson.
I'll tell you what, she is fast. Team Mean Racing. Boat number 239 out of Port Charlotte, Florida, riding for Wade Chapin Performance, Crazy Concepts, and Extreme Throttle is Bobby Cardone.
Out of Naples, Florida, sponsored by Absolute Performance. Boat number 367, Robert Saya, and your winner in the first moto yesterday.
Boat number 425 out of Dawsonville, Georgia, riding for Extreme Throttle, Atlanta Customs, and Swillies, it's Wyatt Hayes.
And out of Carmel, Indiana, boat number 675, Christian Daly.
Boat number 910 out of Cumming, Georgia, riding for Steel Tech, Dedicated Plastic Tanks, and Jet X, Jeff, I don't McPhail.
I don't. I like that.
All right, folks. Taking a look at the results yesterday, Sam Nimi with a 1-3. In the first two motos, Robert Saya with a 2-1. Saya, the playa, from all the way from Naples, Florida, looking to carry a little momentum possibly into our Pro Watercross World Championships.
And, you know, coming into this round, Sam Nimi, as we have been talking about, just indomitable force of nature out of Florida, 339 points. Yeah, Gage Schoenherr in second coming into this with 185. And here's where it gets a little interesting. Ken Waddle in third at the moment with 179. But Ken, unfortunately, if you remember yesterday's
second moto,
had to go out of it and took a 14th.
Wow.
Fouled a plug. Can you believe that?
A $2 plug.
$2 plug.
The whole tour.
Been
racing for 6 months.
He's just killing it, too. Now, mind you, he couldn't make all of the stops, and that also put a little bit of the hurt on this because he's been having some great runs, but he missed round three and round four, St. George, and, it started to rain up here. What? And then also Reno, but regardless, still, let's see. Now, fate not in his hands at this point, right? But I have seen, and so have you, a big mix-up in this class more than once, so let's see what happens today. But right now,
Destiny versus density.
Correct. Keith Dill in fourth with 156 points. And Jeff McPhail in fifth with 111 points. So I'd say with the exception of Sam Nimi, it's still a little bit anybody's game, eh?
Right. There's still a couple podium spots. Well, not really available because they're not going to give them away.
I'm just gonna make a wild guess and say Sam Nimi's probably not much of a gambler because I've noticed he likes to stack the deck in his favor a lot.
Well, he's got a great team, that's for sure,
and
Broward Motorsports.
Helps.
And by the way, congratulations, Broward Motorsports, acquiring Greater Power Sports in West Palm Beach, Florida.
All right, we're just waiting for the sports doc class to fire off. Amateur Ski GP and Ski Limited, you're up next.
Hey, by the way, I'd like to invite everybody to hang out with me next weekend.
Where are you going to be next weekend?
I'm going to be hanging out at North Fort Myers Beach. We're doing a little thing called the U.S. Freestyle East Coast Championships.
That's where you have all the cool jobs.
Come on down and hang out. Oh, yeah. Maybe I'll see you at Connect Sports. I'll be in Grapevine, Texas in 2 days. Come on down to Connect and hang out with us there. Going to be at the golf tournament.
You are?
Yeah,
you
know, imagine that. Did you know I play golf?
I play golf.
Well, I really don't play golf. I drive a golf cart fast.
That's what I thought. The golf cart racer. I was just going to ask you what your handicap was. Which
beer.
One?
Beer.
I didn't say
beer mind. Is my handicap.
Oh, man. Oh, Lord.
All right, folks, here we go. All right, Sam Neamy, looking for one more hole shot this season. Ken Waddle, right to his left.
Ken's like, look, I changed the spark plugs, and I want a hole shot.
Oh,
look at him pushing on Neamy, and Ken actually had the line on that.
He really did. He had that inside line. Looks behind him. Ray Quintana was right there, but Ray went inside out.
All right, it's going to be as they come into that final turn before they pick a split. And Neamy going for the inside. It's going to be Waddle to the outside. So this could be very interesting as they come to the merge because Ken Waddle not pulling up on that gas at all. And nice setup for both of them. But what do you think, Mike?
Well, I'll tell you what. It's going to be Neamy as they come down the front straightaway. Waddle had a good line, as you said. Both of them clean water. Waddle went to the outside. Obviously, the shorter line going to be to the inside. Neamy knew that. That's why he took it. Keith Dill, your current third-place competitor, and he is followed by boat number 910, Jeff McPhail, 31, John Frank Avila. And look at this battle for sixth place there.
Robert Saya, who worked his way up through the pack yesterday as well, back in sixth place.
Saya's kind of like a sleeper. You know, I watched him. He came to my surf and turf races this year. And this is like his first year or second year, actually, that he's come out to go racing. But he's a sleeper. He really don't say much. He just kind of sits back with a sly grin, you know.
Yeah.
And like Hayden Skella was saying, to be built like a jockey. Yeah.
He is a little bit. Yeah,
and he's definitely built like a jockey. Let's see if Saya the Playa can work his way through the crowd because he's got a 2-1 finish so far in the first two motos.
Well, I'll tell you what. He's got his sights set on Frank Avila, and he's already moved up one because he got around Frank from that inside split. So Frank Avila dropping back one. By the way, Frank Avila yesterday had a good start, was up in the top five, got a little sideways, went off his boat, and took a big of a digger right in the upper chest and the head with an Ajax. Yeah. Actually, he's okay, but man, he definitely had some swelling last night.
I talked to him last night. Yeah, he said he got crushed by two Ajaxes. The first one hit him. The second one took him out.
Wow. All right, so...
Yeah, he's got a nice little thing on the top of his forehead.
It
says, I've been hit.
I've been hit. Man down.
Hey, by the way, Trey Frame, we need that Band-Aid back.
Probably need more than one. All right, so Sam Neamy leading and Ken Waddle, one of the teammates from Broward Motorsports, in second place. Waddle, by the way, a teacher. I didn't realize that.
What teacher?
Broward
what?
County.
What, does he teach P.E.?
You wish. All right, Keith Dill. Gentleman that
I know what
actually
Keith
was trying to go side by side with you yesterday on the Party Central, Robert Saya from 7th to 4th.
Hey, by the way, once again, any of you amateur runabout racers, if you would like to get in the pro show today, any of you amateur runabout racers, if you'd like to get in the pro show, please come and see us at the announcing tower, and we will insert you in either the box stock or the GP class. Thank you.
So this one.
one class. This guy's running two classes. He's only going to go through one lap and come in.
Once again, we need race number seven. Race number seven. We need you to the starting line. Amateur Ski GP Ski Limited coming up next to the line. One of our smaller races coming up next. Sam Neamey is your leader, folks. He's working left to right down the back straightaway. And Ken Waddle in tow, followed by Keith Dill on boat number 14, 367. Sayer has moved up into that fourth place position, getting past Team Ambassol.
Ooh, now continuing to push. Hey, Mike, a quick update here. Amateur ski, which is coming up to the line next, is actually only going to do one lap, Mike. So I just want to let you know, Amateur Ski GP and Ski Limited class are only going to do one lap because there's only a couple in there, and those points are not going to shift. And AJ's in multiple classes, just to let you know.
All right.
So that means the IROC stock class and beginner runabout box stock, you need to be right down there on the line.
Yeah, hey, good point.
So there's no reason for you to even wait. In fact, I'd hang over there in staging because it's only going to be one lap for race number. I do believe that's race seven. One lap for race seven. So race number eight, I do want to remind you one more time, race number eight, IROC stock and runabout rec, you need to be getting ready right now too. Beginner runabout box stock, because we're only doing one lap for race number seven. Race number eight, you also need to be down there by the line.
That's right.
Am I saying that right without confusing everybody?
Yeah, you're exactly right. And once again, we're going to get through these 10 races before we go into the pro show program today. And I believe we're also going to try to... I believe we're also going to try to be getting the awards done before the pro show. I'm not quite sure how we're going to do that with, obviously the spotty weather. It is what it is. So
liquid sunshine.
Yeah, liquid sunshine. We got some liquid sunshine.
You're the optimist.
Hey.
All right.
That 20% came through yesterday.
About three laps in, almost four laps in, and already... Neamey finding himself in the not unusual position of working lap traffic. 10 laps is what I just heard from you. Okay. 10 laps, what they're going to be doing on this round. And then as I look back, it's still Ken Waddle with awesome plugs at the moment. It's second. Keith Dill third, and Robert Saya with a toe hook working Keith Dill in fourth.
All right. Looks like there's a lapper in between first and second place, and Waddle able to get around the lapper, top right-hand side of the track. He's on the blue number 95, folks. Sam Neamey working the split. This time he opts to go to the inside section as he's got another back marker on the outside. And that other back marker, I believe, is 675, Christian Daly.
375.
And Neamey able to get around as they work their way around the bubble. And Sam Neamey, man, he's throwing her in cruise control. He's looking at two national titles this year, Don.
Yeah, I just find it so impressive to watch him this year. And as we had talked about yesterday on the live stream, I'm definitely going to mention it a couple more times. It's a gentleman, the only man that came into, or woman that came into this round with a perfect score. So the most you could have brought to Charleston, West Virginia was 360 points from the other rounds. And Sam Neamey did that in Sport GP.
Only racer on the national tour to do that.
That's correct. And I've got to imagine that's pretty rare.
So I guess if you had an MVR, Most Valuable Racer of the Year award, it would probably go to Sam Neamey.
Yeah, no question about it.
By the way, we'd like to say a special hello to Ashley Neamey, who is probably listening in at home.
Hi, Ashley.
We miss you.
Huggles.
Once again, folks, you're watching race number six. This is the sports stock class. Sam Neamey, your leader. Ken Waddle, boat number 95 in second. Keith Dill, boat number 14 in the third spot. But Robert Saya all over Keith Dill like a cheap suit as they work their way top left-hand side of the track. Dill on a Yamaha, Saya on a Sea-Doo. And there they go down the back straightaway. And you can see Saya is actually pulling on Dill. as they work their way to the top right-hand side of the track, sweeping hard as they go into the split section. Dill going to go to the inside. Saya also going to go to the inside, but spins out just a little bit, and that's going to give Dill a little bit of breathing room in that third-place position. Once again, last call. We need race number 7 down to the line. Race number 8 to pre-staging. Once again, race number 7 only going to be a one-lapper. Race number 8, IROC Stock. Begin a runabout box stock. We need you down to the starting line. Thank you. Sam Nemi, the white flag is flying, the hallelujah flag. Hallelujah. Less than one more lap to go for a national championship for the Broward Motorsports pilot. And boy, oh boy, I'll tell you, he has earned it. How about it, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls? How about standing up, clapping, making some noise right now for boat number 13, Sam Nemi, taking the national championship in the sports stock class, which has been the most popular class all season long. Congratulations, Sam. Broward Motorsports in the house. And Sam Nemi going to take first, boat number 95. Ken Waddle also riding for Broward Motorsports, coming through in second. In third place, Keith Dill out of Naples, Florida. Robert Saya rounds out your top four. And you can see the Broward Motorsports guys high-fiving right there. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, all from Florida. Johnny Frankavilla comes through in that fifth place position. Boat number 31, Team Ambassal. In the sixth spot, looks like Ray Quintana also riding for that Broward Motorsports team. Good job, Johnny Frankavilla. Gage Schoenher out of Clearwater Beach, Florida, coming through in the seventh place. Lester out of Michigan coming through in eighth. And that's the way they stack up 1 through 8 there on race number 6. Again, this next race, folks.
I think we're probably set up.
Amateur Ski GP and Ski Limited. Amateur Ski GP and Ski Limited.
Yeah.
Is coming up next. Boat number 12, Isaiah Washington. And boat number 114, AJ Lewinstra. And from what I understand, these guys only going to go about a lap, folks. So race number 8, we're going to need you to the starting line. Again, race number 8, we need you to the starting line. Isaiah Washington, once again, out of Orlando, Florida. He'll be on boat number 12, boat number 114, A.J. Lewinstra, out of El Dorado, Kansas. And A.J. runs for 321 Kawasaki, Hurricane Racing, HydroTurf, Fly Racing, and Hot Products. And by the way, congratulations, A.J. A.J.'s a new uncle. He's a new uncle, that's right. His brother had a new sibling just a day and a half ago, and we'd like to wish that family the best of luck. God bless from the tower.
Are you really writing Mark Gomez, Capricorn, long walks on the beach?
All right, once again, this is going to be a very short race here. Race number 8, we need you to the starting line. Race number 9, stand by. Race number 10, put on your wetsuits. And look at that, Isaiah Washington again with a great jump from the outside. You know, Don, you know why I like Isaiah?
Why?
I like Isaiah because he's a Conor McGregor fan. And we're going to see McGregor Diaz 3 very, very soon, folks. And here comes your leader down the front straight away. It is Isaiah Washington, A.J. Lewinstra in hot pursuit. They work their way around the bubble.
Do you know who left their gear here last night? Whose vest that is? Is that was out with us for a while.
For the first two parties.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I had a smoke on the first day.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Out. Like, now you see me? Yeah, I love that show. I was hoping I was it. I gotta go to the bathroom.
Right, I gotta go to the bathroom.
I'll be right back.
Good luck today, Mark.
Taking the checkered flag there. Congratulations on Isaiah Washington. He'll take the win in that amateur ski GP class. AJ Lewinscher, who's put in a lot of laps this weekend, will take second place. Which brings us to race number eight. That's the IROC stock or runabout rec lights class, combined with the beginner runabout box stock. Down on line, boat number 52, Eric T. Gabriel. Boat number 130 is Eric Gabriel Sr., and he rides for Riva Racing IPD Graphics and the Sea-Doo Bounty X team. Boat number 212, Sean Miles. And representing the beginner runabout box stock class is boat number 003, Rita Spite, and she's out of St. Paul, North Carolina. Once again, folks, this is race number eight. Race number eight coming down to the starting line. Again, folks, race number eight down on the starting line, and we're just getting ready to get started with that one. Again, while we have the opportunity, I'd like to say a very special thanks to Hidden Trails Motorsports, as well as Sea-Doo and Jetlift for all their participation this year on the Pro Watercross National Tour. By the way, we do have our Pro Watercross National Tour event merchandise booth is rolling, and we got Chucky down there. How you doing, Chucky? 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 He's down there. We got t-shirts on sale. I believe they're $20 a piece or $2 for $35. We got the long sleeve t-shirts, which heck, you might need one of those today. Those are $25 a piece or $2 for $45.
Don't be telling me I need a long sleeve shirt.
My goodness, that's what I'm saying. Time for me to head south.
Although I'm kind of getting used to this. Not this weather here, but just in general cool weather already. All right, race number eight is where we're going to next. IROC stock, runabout rec class. I think Mike already did the rundown because I know him and he just doesn't miss a trick. Because he's amazing. We actually waiting on the band, and I think also Bowie. We had to swap out a Bowie. Amateur ski stock is going to be coming at us next, so if you guys could be in stage 80 getting ready. Amateur ski stock, you're going to be next. It just doesn't take very long for Mike Root to switch those out between him and Carson. That's a pretty fast team there.
Yeah, Mike and Drake, Carson.
Drake,
I'll tell you what,
super
yeah,
fast.
It's like a triple threat.
And not just because they're tall. Right. Well, I guess Mike Root's not all that tall.
Right. Well, exactly. He definitely,
Carson and Drake are pretty tall.
He definitely ain't getting an invite to the Cavaliers training camp.
Are you sure? Because he's wily.
Well, maybe the Virginia Cavaliers, but,
oh,
but not the Cleveland Cavaliers.
Snap.
You know, speaking of basketball, how about that whole Kevin Durant thing? Kevin Durant is now going to Golden State. Is Golden State going to be, like, unbeatable next year?
Yes.
I'm telling you. That's like cray-cray.
That is like the third time this year I've actually heard cray-cray come out of your mouth.
I've been hanging out with younger people.
I guess, because that's just not normal. It is usually, that's exactly right. I think Carson's point is very accurate. It's usually
speaking
right after
which,
he has a shark energy drink.
Speaking of which.
You've had two now. This is the number two.
Yeah,
this is your final shark of the day, you realize
this. My final shark of the tour. I got three more races,
well,
and
let's
I'm
do a
back
toast.
To Florida. Let's have a toast.
Have,
there
look,
you go.
Look how I stole the shark.
Let's have some toast.
Shark steal. Bam.
Bam.
Special thanks, by the way, to our brand new sponsor for the 2016 tour, Shark Energy Drink. And I heard that one of the reasons that they wanted to jump on was because they heard all the funny banter between Mike Young and I last year about the minute you took one of those the first time from Brock Austin. It was trouble in the tower.
Brock's my buddy, man. I like Brock. Hey, speaking of Brock Austin, you know, I was talking to Carrie yesterday, and they're looking at putting on a bunch of races out on the West Coast next year, man. I think that is absolutely fantastic.
Yeah, I think that's cool they're doing that, too. You know, it's not like they're busy or anything, running a national tour, going international, running a business. Why not? Let's go ahead and promote some races, too, because, you know, that's right. A hard-working crew is what I'm saying.
Carrie Austin, I'd just like to say welcome to my world.
Yeah, we love you. Welcome to my world. That wasn't a threat, by the way.
Yeah, I mean, it wasn't a threat. Yeah, exactly. It was a promise.
It was a promise.
Oh, yeah. Time to get all them dancing shoes. Trivia question, Dawn. Who sings this song? What's the name of the band?
I got nothing.
You got nothing? Think about what you eat for your birthday.
Cake.
Cake. That's it, baby.
Thank you for the help.
Money. Yeah, you eat money? No, I just bite my gold.
Bite my gold.
Yarr.
So we need to get you for the 2017 tour a grill. We get you like a gold grill.
I have a hard enough talking on Saturday mornings. You throw some extra teeth in there, man. I'll be all messed
that
up.
Visual, just hilarious. Some dollar bill rings.
Some dollar bill rings, yeah. That's about what these cost.
Oh, man.
Been a fun tour, man. Been a fun 2016. Thanks, everybody, for hanging out with us on this national tour, man. Dawn, I'll tell you what. Love you guys. That's all.
I love you, too. You're a class act, my friend.
We love Mark Gomez, too, man. Gomez is the man.
We like you a little bit.
Even though Flores has some Gomez envy. Flores got Gomez envy. That's what he got.
Gomez envy.
Ouch. Is that horizontally or vertically? yeah, a little bit of Pitbull going out to all of our friends here in Charleston, West Virginia. Good morning, Charleston. You're watching the Hidden Trails Sea-Doo. Pro Watercross National Tour presented by Jet Lift. And out on the track right now, we got our IROC stock class. And Eric Gabriel is your current leader out there, Eric Gabriel Sr. France, the UK, a bit Brazil. Buoys have been replaced, and I believe that's Eric Gabriel Jr. back there in that second place position. Dad's going to go to the inside, Junior going to go to the outside. We need race number 9, folks. Race number 9. Please work your way down to the starting line. Once again, race number 9. We need you to the starting line. That's the amateur runabout box stock. Check that. That's race 10. We need you down to the line, too, race 10.
Eric Gabriel Sr. with the whole shot.
Amateur ski stock should be down online. Nikki Turner, Brandon Edwards, Wyatt Hayes, AJ Lewinstra, Dawson Newby, Brett Underhill, and Jamie Palmer. Please report down to the starting line.
Six laps here.
Six laps to glory here in race number 8. And Eric Gabriel, current leader out of Allentown, Michigan, sponsored by Arriva Motorsports. And Casey Malden over at IPD Graphics. And Gabriel hanging way off the side of that boat there. Big sweep and turn here, bottom left hand side of the track. Once again, folks, race number 8. Gabriel, your leader, as he comes around the bubble. Eric Gabriel Jr. Once again, we have race number 9. Race number 9, please report to the starting line. Eric Gabriel, still your leader out there as the podium comes up. By the way, Don Dawson, I'd like to invite everybody to hang out with us in Pacific City, Oregon, where we're going to be in just a couple of weeks, man.
Yeah.
The Blowsion Surf
Bam.
Slam.
I can't wait. I'm going to bring my helmet. I am. I'm serious.
The helmet that Johnny made for us.
That is correct.
Yeah, and I'm going to bring my helmet there.
All right.
We're going to bring our helmets.
That's why I told you.
I was going to say, I ain't riding, though.
I'm going to also bring my race helmet. I ain't riding, though. Well, I might ride. Mark will let me ride his boat. Yeah. Maybe not. He used to. I don't think it was that expensive.
He'll let you ride his boat while it's on the trailer, while he's bringing it to the beach.
Hey, don't be making fun of me now. He let me ride his boat a couple years ago. He's doing freestyle Pictionary for me.
Right, exactly. I love this stuff because actually I'm learning stuff too up here.
Actually, it looks like a bunch of ants in a herd.
Yeah,
but
by the way,
it's really cool.
Mark is no Leonardo da Vinci, that's for sure.
Well, really.
The
he
stick
did
figures
say
are good.
He did Express last night, though.
Hey, it's a
Sheridan. Hey, by the way, congratulations, Eric Gabriel. Taking the win there and taking the national championship in that IROC 1000cc and underclass. Congratulations, Eric, and welcome back to the tour after your 15-year hiatus.
Right. And then taking a championship on top of it.
Yeah.
Down on the line, amateur ski stock out of Cornelius, North Carolina on the double-aught boat is Nikki Turner.
Boat number 41 comes to us from Henderson, Nevada, riding for Hot Products. RO Truck and Equipment, as well as Skatrack, Rido Power, Bell Helmets, ODI Grips, Jet Pilot, and Spy Optics, Brandon Edwards.
Out of Dawsonville, Georgia, sponsored by Extreme Throttle, Atlantic Customs, and Swillies, boat number 86, Wyatt Hayes.
Boat number 114 out of El Dorado, Kansas, riding for 321 Kawasaki, Hurricane Racing, HydroTurf, Fly Racing, and Hot Products, AJ Lou Instra.
From Eaton, Colorado, sponsored by Team Faith, Fly Racing, WPS, Pirelli, KTM, Jetlift, Pro Watercraft Racing, Amsoil, Jet Dynamic, M&M Marine, Sunstar, Tubeless, and Liquid Performance. It is boat 316, Dawson Newby.
And boat number 417, possibly our rookie of the year, out of Pensacola, Florida, it's Brent Underhill.
Out of Youngsville, North Carolina, sponsored by Hurricane Racing, Riva, Rhino Power, IPD Graphics, and Amsoil. Boat number 721, J.B. Palmer.
And that rounds out your field of competitors. This is race number 9. One more race to go before the amateur season comes to a close.
Well, and I got to say a couple of cool shout-outs here in the amateur ski stock class. First off, Brandon Edwards with his first moto win happened yesterday. And looking to sit on a podium for this weekend, actually. He's got a fourth-place first finish and a first-place second finish. Gentleman that also is rocking it is A.J. Lewinstra.
Ah, looking at his possible first hole shot of the year. Dawson Newby coming from the Arena Cross Series. The heck with them wheels, I'm getting me a keel.
He's out of Eaton, Colorado, and as Mike so eloquently mentioned, he actually hails from the Arena Cross background, and I tell you what, great rider, and currently sitting in the lead. AJ Lewinstra wanting to spoil that first time, see if he's able to do it as Dawson picks the outside.
Yeah, probably a pretty good choice. It looks like...
It's AJ up on that inside split, but it's also Wyatt Hayes.
Oh!
Wyatt took a big rinse and repeat.
Yeah, exactly.
AJ Lewinstra getting around him, and that is your battle for the hole shot, and literally about seven or eight inches between
long.
Them. Yeah, it looked like AJ Lewinstra going to pull the hole shot. Newbie second.
And it looks like Brandon Edwards back there in the third spot, now moving into second.
Brandon on the gas with that first place yesterday. Man, he has got some mojo going into this third moto.
Brandon also doing a great job 2 weeks ago at Greg Mad Dog Mattis race over in Pahrump, Nevada, the Super Arena World Cup.
Looks like Wyatt Hayes getting around Dawson Newby, just going down on the water ever so briefly on that double yellow before they hit the backstretch and allowed Wyatt to move into third, Newby in fourth.
Race number 10, right about normally aspirated and amateur box stock. Please report to the line.
I got a good memory.
Amateur runabout box stock. Please report to the starting line. You too, Cameron Frame. Come on down here. You're going to take that number one plate away from Greenwald so we don't have to hear it anymore. By the way, Rick Ignacio wants to slow things down a little bit. Hardest working man in show business. Rick, been great working with you all season long. AJ Lewinstra, once again, in the lead, followed by Brandon Edwards. Edwards with a pole in the water, trying to reel it in. Bottom left-hand side of the track, that's where the action's at. And Newby, who pulled the hole shot, slides all the way back to fifth spot. Wyatt Hayes in the third place position, and here comes Jesse Palmer. Boat number 721, currently riding in that fourth spot. AJ Lewinstra, I believe, your current points leader here in the amateur ski stock class. Again, riding for 3-2-1 Kawasaki and Bill Hagen Company over at Hurricane Racing. Your leader's top right-hand side of the track, still Lou Winstra. And he's got Brandon Edwards right there in his back pocket. Both Lou Winstra and Edwards going to the inside split. Again, final amateur race of the season should be down online. And just as a reminder to all of our amateurs, we will be doing the awards immediately following race number 10. We will be doing the amateur awards. The amateur awards will be held right behind the stage immediately following race number 10. Thank you. By the way, Evan Krepsky, if you are in the hizzle, you left your life jacket here and your race stand, your ski stand. It is still here as well. It's located right down here in front of the announcing tower. Once again, Evan Krepsky left some equipment here yesterday. That's all right. This town's so honest, nobody took it. Once again, green flag still out from the flag stand as we take a look down there, bottom right-hand side of the track. That's where you find your flag stand, folks, in case you haven't been here all weekend. Oh, and Edwards goes off the side of his boat. Tough break, man. He was right on the tail of Lewinstra coming around the bubble. And now we've got a goggle adjustment.
No, Edwards, go.
And Edwards, here comes Wyatt Hayes. And Edwards pops back up in the tray. Eight laps to glory in this one here. And I believe we're about six down, folks. White flag now coming out for Lewinstra. Once again, Lewinstra coming all the way from Kansas to be here and join us in Charleston this weekend. Certainly thankful for all of the folks that have come from far and wide, descended upon Charleston, West Virginia to be here with us this weekend. Again, been a pleasure being the tour announcer for the last 20 plus years. Last race of my season coming up next.
Nice check. All right. Congratulations to AJ Lewinstra. Great work on that one. And man, I tell you, Brandon Edwards had the gas rolling on it. Unfortunately, took a little spin dip in the horseshoe section and it not only put him down in the water, but cost him a little visibility. He had to rip his goggles off. And anytime you guys have ever raced, you'll understand just how detrimental that can be. So able to hold on to that. Looks like Brandon might be in on a third. And give him an opportunity still for a podium today. So congratulations to Brandon Edwards with his first moto win yesterday. And also congratulations to AJ Lewinster. We have one more race to go before we go to the awards for amateur. And then we're going to be going to our television show. Thank you, by the way, for understanding. We've had a lot of silence or just Mike on the microphone today, who's, as usual, he does best job on the planet. We love him. As we get prepped for this TV show. Definitely a little change of pace today, for sure. Okay, we got 30 minutes, by the way, to do awards. So what I'm going to have you guys do is we're going to do amateur awards right down here on the stage behind the announcing tower. So if I could have you guys get ready and head on down here. We are doing awards right after this final race. We're going to start with that. So if we could have you guys make your way down. By the way, heads up, you guys, we'll be doing, just because we're waiting on results for one of the classes, sport stock will be last on the award program, but we are going to be doing awards right after this race. We're going to have about 30 minutes to do that. Right now, amateur runabout box stock is on the line and out of the gate even. So out of South Lyon, Michigan, sponsored by JBL Med, HDD, Riva, and Jet Pilot. It is boat number 35, Jason Lester, out of Medellin, Colombia, sponsored by Liquid Militia, WWR Products, HydroTurf, and Ronnie Mack. C1, Juan Wada, the Canadian Colombian, out of South Charleston, West Virginia. Boat number 624 is Brian Fields, and he got Juan Rada in second. Jason Lester with the hole shot at boat number 624, Brian Fields in third. And man, this is just a repeat of yesterday. Exact same finish, in fact, in first and second motos, and they are going to have the exact same finish unless something changes on this final moto. You are watching the final race of the amateur classes for the 2016 Hidden Trail Sea-Doo Pro Watercross National Tour, presented by Jetlift. On behalf of all of the staff and all the fans and sponsors, I want to say a special thank you to every one of the competitors today for being here, not just today, but for the whole National Tour. I realize that's a huge commitment for you. We love you guys so much. Thank you for being a part of this, and now we can't wait to give you the well-deserved props. So we're going to be doing that award ceremony before we do the pro show, which I think is pretty cool, and that allow you to sit back and relax and fully enjoy the pro show. So again, we love you, and just to let you know, those awards are going to be down at the tower, and we're going to be starting this right after this final race. So amateur awards at the tower right after this final race. My name is Dawn Dawson, up here with the incredibly talented Mr. Mikey Young. And also here with Mark Gomez in the house. We're going to be rolling out a brand new trick from Mark Gomez, and I'll tell you about that a little bit later.
Okay, some of them.
Hey, Dawn. Dawn, by the way, we still need some runabout racers that would like to jump in the class.
Check. Hey, Mikey. You got me all excited. I dropped the microphone on the floor.
Hey, one of the things I wanted to ask you real quick, Dawn, is we're going to have a meeting. Any of those runabout racers that had signed up to jump in those classes, please meet with AJ. And AJ, where do you want to meet with them? Once again, all runabout entries, please meet with AJ. And
where do you want to meet with him?
Down. Hang on. Right down here by
Pro Watercross.
At the Pro Watercross Tour merchandise booth. Once again, the Pro Watercross Tour merchandise booth. All runabout racers that are going to be racing this afternoon, please meet with AJ down at the Pro Watercross event merchandise booth. Dawn, back to you.
Thank you, sir. Nothing's changed down on the track. We've only got a couple more laps to go. It's been pretty interesting to get the opportunity to watch Jason Lester, gentleman on board boat number 35. And, man, he has definitely been pretty flawless out here. As the white flag comes out, he won this moto, both these motos yesterday, and he's currently in the lead. Just a couple more turns for him to go, and he's going to lock this down for the weekend. Juan Rada, the definitely one of the most hilarious characters on the national tour. If you have not met Juan, that is something you should just put on a bucket list. Really, just take 5 minutes with that guy. He's one of the funnest guys we've ever had a chance to hang out with. Let me just tell you, anytime you see somebody sponsored by Ronnie Mac, that's when you know you got to meet him. That's a character judgment right there. Hello, Justin.
Some of the tricks that you're going to be doing, background information on you guys, how many times, you know, the years you've competed, how you got started, just anything. I know your sponsors already, but anything, any kind of trivia stuff, favorite trick. Oh, thanks, bud.
All right, you guys, that is, they say, is a wrap. It is check your flag down for Jason Lester and Juan Rada. Juan, you did amazing. And look at him. He's such a poser in such a fun way. Juan Rada.
You're the Juan.
You are the Juan. Get it? Art. Oh, that was just awful.
All right. You guys got awards. You got that all handled.
Congratulations again, Jason Lester, Juan Rada, and Brian Fields. And we are going to be doing the awards coming at you next, right behind the announcer tower. Again, all amateurs, going to have you start making your way down. We're going to be doing the awards next, and we are going to have to go through that pretty quick, you guys. We only have 30 minutes, I believe, before we go to 12 o'clock. And once we do that, we're going right to the TV.
I think opening statements, but you might check with Ray in the trailer.